in the beginning, the Lord made the earth, the heavens, the hills, and the seas. Then he created the sun and the stars, the land, the fruit, the trees. He made all creatures that live in the earth and taught them to live by his plan. Then, as he rested, the Lord sanctified the seventh day for man. Molded in the image of his maker, man shall have dominion over all. But because we're nothing more than human, sometimes we stumble, sometimes we fall. In the beginning, the world was so bright, perfection was there for all men. So pray and believe in the Lord's holy light, and we'll have perfection again.
And God created the world and man. Then God looked around and said, "It's not good for the man to be alone. I'll make him a partner." So God put Adam to sleep, took one of his ribs, and when he woke up, God had built him a mate. And Adam said, "Bone of my bones, flesh of my flesh, she shall be called woman."
Eve, don't you know that God loves you so? He only asks that you not disobey. He gave you the world. What were you thinking, girl, to let the devil take it all away?
Don't eat the fruit in the garden, Eve. It wasn't in God's natural plan. You were only a rib, and look at what you did to Adam, the father of man.
Eve, I've heard it said that no one would be dead if only you had picked the other tree. From the garden you were barred, and there's an angel standing guard to protect the tree of life eternally.
Don't eat the fruit in the garden, Eve. It wasn't in God's natural plan. You were only a rib, and look at what you did to Adam, the father of man.
The world grew, and God regretted the way things turned out. He said, "I created man, and I'm sorry I ever made them. I'm going to wipe them off the face of the earth." But one man, Noah, found grace in the eyes of the Lord.
found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. That is the reason the scriptures record. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord.
Now the Lord looked down from his window in the sky and said,
I created man, but I don't remember why. Nothing but fighting since creation day. I'll send a little water and I'll wash him all away.
So the Lord came down to look around a spell, and there he found Noah behaving mighty well. And that's the reason the scriptures record that Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord.
Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. That is the reason the scriptures record. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord.
The Lord said,
Noah, there's gonna be a flood. There's gonna be some water. There's gonna be some mud. Take off your hat, Noah, and take off your coat. Get Ham, Shem, and Japheth and build yourself a boat.
Noah said,
Lord, I don't believe I could.
The Lord said,
Noah, get some sturdy gopher wood. You never know what you can do till you try. Build it 50 cubits wide and 30 cubits high.
Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. That is the reason the scriptures record. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord.
Then Noah said,
there she is.
There she is, Lord.
The Lord said,
Noah, it's time to get aboard. Now take a creature, a he and a she, and of course Mrs. Noah and the whole family.
Noah said,
Lord, it's getting mighty dark.
The Lord said,
Noah, get these creatures in the ark.
Noah said,
Lord, it's beginning to pour.
The Lord said,
Noah, hurry up and shut the door.
Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. That is the reason the scriptures record. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord.
Now the ark rose up on the foot of the deep, and after 40 days, Mr. Noah took a peek. Said,
we're not moving, Lord. Where are we at?
The Lord said,
you're sitting on Mount Ararat.
Noah said,
Lord, it's getting mighty dry.
The Lord said,
Noah, see the rainbow in the sky. Take all the creatures and people to earth. And don't be more trouble than you're worth.
Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. And he landed high and dry. And he landed high and dry. And he landed high and dry.
Well, God got things back together, and the world started growing again. Noah's sons had sons, and a descendant of Shem's was a man called Abram. God handpicked him, made him the leader of his race, the founder of his religion, and changed his name to Abraham. His trust in God was like nothing you've ever seen before. The father of the faithful, the father of all that believe.
God told Abraham to go to Canaan land and start a brand new life and be a brand new man. He took his wife and nephew and did as he was told. But it's hard starting over at 75 years old. But God said, Abraham, look, for as far as you see, all of that land is a gift from me. It's a lesson for the learning, for the likes of you and me. Just have a little faith and you'll see.
Well, Abraham was closing in on 99, and Sarah, bless her heart, wasn't very far behind. When God stopped in to visit in the heat of the day, said pretty soon there'll be a baby coming your way. But Sarah laughed and said, no, I don't believe that it's true. Be with a child, with an old man like you.
It's a lesson for the learning, for the likes of you and me. Just have a little faith and you'll see.
Abraham, it's time for the big sacrifice. Build yourself a fire. Sharpen up your knife, take your little boy Isaac and put him in the flame and kill him and burn him in God's holy name. Then God said, Abraham, don't. It was only a test. You passed with flying colors, ahead above the rest.
It's a lesson for the learning, for the likes of you and me. Just have a little faith and you'll see.
the father of the faithful, the leader of the clan. He started out as just a simple country man, but God loved Abraham, and Abraham loved him. It's a story to remember when your faith is growing dim and you get tired and you say, oh, it was different back then. But remember that they were only just men.
It's a lesson for the learning for the likes of you and me. Just have a little faith and you'll see. Just have a little faith and you'll see. Just have a little faith and you'll see.
Well, Joseph had the faith, and he could see. He could see into the future, interpret dreams, and predict world crises. Joseph was sold into slavery in Egypt and rose from prisoner to royalty because of his special talent, a talent God gave him, and God made all his dreams come true.
Joseph had a coat of many colors. Joseph had a closet full of dreams that told how he would one day rule his brothers and tore his life apart right at the seams. Cause Joseph's brothers sold him into slavery and sent him on his way to Egypt land. And the day the dreamer started out for Egypt, nightmare of Israel began.
The dreamer made his bed in Pharaoh's kingdom, but his master's woman lay for him. It seems she had her own dreams for the dreamer and sent him up when he would not give in.
Pharaoh got word about the dreamer, cause Pharaoh took to dreaming on his own. Pharaoh took a liking to the dreamer, set him free and called him to the throne.
The dreams that he interpreted for Pharaoh told about the famine yet to come. He rationed out the food in Pharaoh's kingdom so there'd be enough for everyone.
The dreamer sent a message to his father, said, I'm alive and well in Egypt's land. Said he'd made a place for them beside him, for them to come and share his dreams with him.
Joseph had a coat of many colors. Joseph had a purpose to pursue. Joseph had forgiveness for his brother. The dreamer had a dream and it came true. Yeah, Joseph had a dream and it came true.
Before he died, Joseph predicted that God would someday bring the children of Israel back to Canaan. Moses was an Israelite born in Egypt. He grew up in the home of Pharaoh and was treated as one of the family. One day when he saw one of his fellow Jews being beaten by an Egyptian guard, he killed the guard and had to run for his life. Years later, God came to Moses, who was still in exile, in the form of a burning bush. There's a purpose in every life. And that's when Moses found his.
God promised to lead his children out of bondage. He said he'd free them from Pharaoh's evil hand. He said he'd guide and protect them on their journey and lead them to the promised land.
God's children were slaves in Egypt land, so God took Moses by the hand. He said, Moses, tell old Pharaoh to set them free. But Moses wanted a way to get out, cause in his mind he's beginning to doubt. And he said, Lord, old Pharaoh, he ain't gonna listen to me.
Now the Lord said, son, throw down that rod. Old Moses did, and he cried to God, 'cause it turned to a snake as evil and wicked as sin. Well, then he cried again with an awful wail, and the Lord said, seize him by the tail. Old Moses did, and it turned to a rod again.
God promised to lead his children out of bondage. He said he'd free them from Pharaoh's evil hand. He said he'd guide and protect them on their journey and lead them to the promised land.
Well, the Lord said, Moses, I've got power, and I'll be with you every hour. Said, go tell Pharaoh to set my children free. Well, Moses did, but the Lord helped out. He sent a plague to the land about, so old Pharaoh told him to go and let him be. Well, they started out with a cloud by day and a fire by night to lead the way, but old Pharaoh suddenly decided to change his mind. So he gathered together his soldier band, got all them chariots throughout the land, said, I'll let them Israelites go some other time.
God promised to lead his children out of bondage. He said he'd free them from Pharaoh's evil hand. He said he'd guide and protect them on their journey and lead them to the promised land.
Well, they came to the banks of the old Red Sea, turned to Moses and started to plea, and Moses fell on his knees and there in the sand. The Lord said, Moses, trust in God, 'cause all you gotta do is just raise that rod and over these mighty waters stretch your hand. Well, Moses followed the Lord's command, the waters parted, and there in the sand they saw a path that led to the other shore. Well, the ground was dry, and they passed on through, and old Pharaoh's army thought they would too, but the waters fell, and ain't never been seen no more.
God promised to lead his children out of bondage. He said he'd free them from Pharaoh's evil hand. He said he'd guide and protect them on their journey and lead them to the promised land.
While they were traveling in the wilderness on the way to Canaan, there was a need for law and order among the people, who were getting more restless every day. Moses set up the court, and God laid down the law.
Moses led God's children out to find the promised land. And on the way he'd stop each day and look to heaven and ask God for help, as he could not withstand the task alone. And then one day he looked away, and thereby lay a stone. God said, write upon this stone these words I say to you, and if you'll all obey my rules, I'll see you safely through. God opened heaven's doors, and then he guided Moses' hand and said, go and tell my children, these are my commands. Go and climb that mountain, Moses, climb that mountain now and pray. Find that mountain now and tell us what our Lord has had to say.
Thou shalt have no gods before me is my first command. And thou shalt not make any graven image by thy hand. Thou shalt not take my name in vain if thou would guiltless be. Remember thou to keep the Sabbath day alone for me. Honor thy father and thy mother, and thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not commit adultery, and thou shalt not steal. Love thy neighbor as thyself, and show thy neighbor peace. Covet not thy neighbor's house, nor anything that's his.
Go and climb that mountain, Moses, climb that mountain now and pray. Find that mountain now and tell us what our Lord has had to say.
Moses showed these words of God to all the children then. They pulled up stakes and headed out to find the promised land that Moses had described to them and told of comforts there that children of oppression thought they'd not find anywhere. But they were soon to part from him and push along a while, for it was never meant for him to walk that final mile. The children cried, if we must go on, Moses, without you, then talk to God just one more time and tell us what to do.
Go and climb that mountain, Moses, climb that mountain now and pray. Climb that mountain now and tell us what our Lord has had to say. Go and climb that mountain, Moses, climb that mountain now and pray. Climb that mountain now and tell us what our Lord has had to say.
Years passed and Israel was in trouble again. Shamgar, Deborah, Gideon, Abimelech, Tola, Elon, and more were all judges and deliverers of Israel. This time the Philistines had them. Others were to come to finish the work, but God chose Samson to strike the first blow to free the Israelites.
Oh, Samson, it's been said you were a mighty man. I've heard it said you killed a lion with your hand. And when the people of Philistia raised your iron, ain't you the man who set their fields on fire? You faced an army of Philistines all alone, and didn't you tear at their flesh with just a bone? So tell me, Samson, if these things I hear are true, how could you let a woman get the best of you?
I've heard it said you were the best of many men, that you could tear a city gate right off its hinge, and that the strongest rope just could not hold you bound, and you completely tore one temple down.
How could you let yourself get caught in such disgrace? You got the best of every man you ever faced. And after all the mighty enemies you slew,
how could you let a woman get the best of you?
You've battled many a man till he has turned and fled, then turned around, let a woman turn your head. You loved the best of man, but you were bound to fall by the very thing that you loved best of all.
Oh, Samson, it's been said you were a mighty man, and women were your weakness, this I understand. But after all the mighty armies you went through,
how could you let a woman get the best of you? Oh, Samson, it's been said you were a mighty man, and women were your weaknesses, I understand. But after all the mighty armies you went through, how could you let a woman get the best of you? How could you let Delilah get the best of you?
Sometimes called the last of the judges and the first of the prophets was Samuel. He was truly a judge, a prophet, a priest, and a kingmaker. He personally anointed Saul king of Israel and later did the same thing to David, who was the shepherd son of Jesse and great-grandson of Ruth.
Jesse, shepherd to his father's sheep, played the harp when Saul got weary, rocked the giant till he was fast asleep.
People praised
when Saul killed thousands, when David killed 10,000, they cheered. And
all that noise
made Saul angry, and the shepherd was on the lam for years. David was a man down
shepherd king of all. But through it all, God loved him and forgave him. David, the man who'd done it all. Bathsheba, wife of Uriah, took a bath under David's watchful eye. He fell in love and took her body. Then he sent Uriah out to die. He was weak, like you and I are. And as a sinner, David did his part. But God said, this man David, there's a man after my own heart. David was a man down in Israel, fighter, lover, shepherd, king of law. But through it all, God loved him and forgave him. David, the man who done it all. Ah, David, the man who done it all.
Solomon was the son of the Gentile adulteress Bathsheba and David, Israel's greatest king. As king, he built the temple that God would not let his father build. And in his reign, he asked God for two things, wisdom and knowledge. This is the Song of Solomon.
The Lord appeared to Solomon and asked him in his dream, just what would you want if I would grant you anything? King Solomon said to the Lord, on riches I won't dwell. Just grant to me the wisdom, Lord, lead your people well.
When he woke, the Lord had blessed the throne on which he sat, and nobody ever caught him sleeping after that. People heard about him and came from far and wide. He'd lay his words of wisdom on and open up their eyes.
And didn't Solomon have it all together? Didn't Solomon lead his people well? Didn't Solomon have it all together? Don't his words ring clearly as a bell?
Two women came to Solomon, both had given birth. I'm troubled, oh dear kindly king, please help me, said the first. One night while I was sleeping, this woman's baby died. She laid its body on my bosom, trading it for mine.
The other woman said to him that it was not true, and Solomon said, bring the child, I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll divide him with the sword and half to each disperse. The real mother cried, oh no, just give the child to her.
And didn't Solomon have it all together? Didn't Solomon lead his people well? Didn't Solomon have it all together? Don't his words ring clearly as a bell? Didn't Solomon have it all together?
This was the end of the United Kingdom of Israel for centuries. The prophets told the people there was something yet to come, someone greater than Israel had ever seen. Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, they all told the story. And this is the way Daniel told it.
Here is a story from the good book we know, a story about a miracle that happened long ago. We hope that you'll take courage when temptation you meet. There's somebody watching you who's strong when you're weak.
They wouldn't bend.
They held on to the will
of God, so we're told.
They wouldn't bow.
They would not bow their knees to the idol made of gold.
They wouldn't burn.
They were protected by the fourth man in the fire. They wouldn't bend. They wouldn't bow. They wouldn't burn.
Now the prophet Daniel tells about three men who walked with God. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, before the wicked king they stood. And the king commanded them bow and throne in the fiery furnace that day. But the fire was so hot that the men were slain who forced them on their way. Now when the three were cast in and the king rose up to witness this awful fate, he began to tremble at what he saw, and in astonished tones he spake. Did we not cast three men bound into the midst of that fire? Well, oh, I see four men unhurt, unbound, and walking down there. There's Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, and the fiery coals they trod. And the form of the fourth man that I see is like the Son of God.
They held on to the will of God, so we are told.
They wouldn't bow.
They would not bow their knees to the idol made of gold.
They
were protected by the fourth man in the fire. They wouldn't bend, they wouldn't bow, they wouldn't burn.
They wouldn't bend.
They held on to the will of God, so we are told.
They wouldn't bow.
They would not bow their knees to the idol made of gold.
They wouldn't burn.
They were protected by the fourth man in the fire.
They wouldn't bend.
They wouldn't bow. They wouldn't burn.
They wouldn't bend.
They held on to the will of God, so we are told.
They wouldn't bend.
They would not bow their knees to the idol made of gold.
They wouldn't bend.
They were protected by the fourth man in the fire.
They wouldn't bend. They wouldn't bow.
The word was the law, the blood was grace. But there would be a day of no more blood sacrifices. One supreme sacrifice would serve all future generations. Isaiah said, "The Lord himself shall give you a sign. A virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel, Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace."
I can hear the chariots rumble. I can see the marching throng. The flurry of God's trumpets spell the end of sin and wrong. Regal robes are now unfolding. Heaven's grand stands all in place. Heaven's choir is now assembled. Start to sing amazing grace. For the King is coming. The King is coming. I just heard the trumpet sounding. And now his face I see. For the King is coming. The King. Praise God, he's coming for me. Happy faces line the hallways, those whose lives have been redeemed. Broken homes that he has mended, those from prison he has freed. Little children and the aged, hand in hand stand all aglow. Who were crippled, broken, ruined, clad in garments white as snow. For the King is coming. The King. I just heard the trumpet sounding, and now his face I see. Oh, the King is coming, the King.